This video will walk through exercise 7 and show how we can use the channels feature to receive value updates in real time. First, we will need to give a path to the PI tag that we want to monitor and retrieve the web ID using a normal HTTP request. We'll then substitute in that web ID to the URL for our request to the channel endpoint of the stream controller. We'll also need to add a basic authentication header similar to what we did in Postman. In this case, we just need to fill out our password. We can then run the script, and our WebSocket client will wait for updates from the PyWeb API. Each time our WebSocket receives a new message, the onMessage function will be called, and the message content will be output to the console. We can manually write a value to the tag through PySystem Management tools, and we see that the value comes through the WebSocket almost immediately. We can press Ctrl-C to stop the script. We'll run it again, this time looking for updates on all attributes under the B117 element. In addition to updating the path, we'll change our channel URI to go to the Stream Set Controller instead. We'll also add URL parameters to specify that we want to include initial values and to receive a heartbeat every 5 seconds. The heartbeat can give us confirmation that the WebSocket is still functioning even if there are no new values coming through. For the bonus section, we're asked to look at all of the currently running channel instances, which can be done using the channel instances endpoint. Here we see some information about the channel we currently have open and running.